Tell me, what's $20, 5, 10, 15.
Money is everything. Even though you only match out for 3 years, I would never quit working for you.
You're lucky.
No, you're lucky. I'm blessed.
I mean, you're fortunate. You have mother to support you.
That's what she says. Oh, Mr. Dodd, before I came to work for you, my life was planned, dog, and born.
You're a good kid, a little bit crazy. But I didn't tell them. Thanks for sticking.
Oh, Mr. Dollar.
You're my girl Friday every day of the week.
Every day of the week?
That includes Sundays.
Sundays?
Girl, when you came in the mail?
Envelope.
What was it? Indian.
Ah. Ew. This will last me up for some tribute to retirement home tomorrow. Another bill.
Why is it the invoice in this town named Bill? If things don't improve, I may have to close up the shop and open up a donut stand.
Oh no, Mr. Dog! Don't say that! Gosh, of course! Forget you said that, but you can't be serious! This is the best job I've ever had! It's the only job I've ever had! Oh, don't close the
door! I did my work and I want my dollar, dollar!
Third week degree, Mr. Dog, I'm sure.
Looks to me like she's already here.
Treasure out?
It is your business, ma'am, Foundation.
I handed out most of them. I didn't throw none down the sewer. You said you'd give me a dollar.
I always keep my word. I've got some change somewhere.
Just so it ain't somewhere over the rainbow. Get it! That bird, is that a Maltese falcon?
No, it's a California chicken. Mr. Dollar is a luck charm.
Good luck charm? The chicken must be on strike. Hey, Dollar, did I tell you about my brother Link? He's missing. We call him the Missing Link.
I'm glad to hear you, Dollar.
I guess I left my change in my other pair of pants.
You only got one pair of pants, and you're wearing them.
Flores.
Sure, Mr. Dollar, don't you worry about it. I'll get my pants.
You sure you're in the right racket? Somehow it don't seem sensible. Me walking up and down the street, handing out wallpaper for a private eyeball.
That's what I'm going to say.
No wonder business is lousy.
You've been seen to me, old man. me tell you something.
Thank you. you. I hate fried eyes.
You only think you do.
Exercise, exercise, exercise.
Practice for a quarter.
Gotta keep it cheap.
What do you mean keep it cheap? You've never been in cheap. What do you got?
Detective Doyle!
I'm only doing this to pay you back for that time you tipped me off about that phony tofu rack. Imagine trying to pass off marshmallows on a bamboo skewer. Genuine tofu.
Life is
beautiful. Here's the file in the Stockholm Mission case.
You know what, Dollar?
He's not something to forget. Private detective.
How does 5,000 sound?
Nice, but how compliment these lucky dollar fishing.
It took a special sort of woman to keep Throckmorton Midport interested. I have complete confidence in your abilities. Sir, you don't carry any of my traps.
$5,000!
Lucky Dollar's attention agency. No job too small, no lead too tall. Lucky Dollar, private eye and ear speaking.
Hello, Lucky. Please, the door is open. I have a confession to make.
Yeah? Samantha Rice?
I can't explain her to you, but no extraordinary thing has happened.
Yeah?
Throckmorton's car.
You mean the horse?
Is that Pandora?
I thought you said your name was Samantha.
No one's called me Pandora. Are you calling me?
I'm trying to.
Is that Samantha?
You mean Pandora?
Pandora, you've got to call me.
Before I should get my thoughts together, I'm not. He sounded as if he heard it.
Yeah, what's that one?
Looks like I'm back on the case, Miss Sugarman.
Right, Lucky.
Yes, Samantha?
Thanks for the better cheese.
Ordinarily, I'd kiss off the deal. I like people who say who they are.
Clint.
Yes?
I like people who say who they are. And now this way. Okay, every time I say the money is getting in the curb, and it's not going to stay
here. I like people stay who they are. But there was something about Samantha and Pandora that is beautiful. Maybe it was those soft, maybe the wise, or the way she had bad lashes. Maybe it was because I just plain needed a job. Anyhow, I figured I'd just commit without them. And once I was in that case, strictly Section 8, what I wanted to see for myself.
A gentleman to see you, Mrs. Mayport.
I don't like visitors.
I can't help that.
What's his name?
Lucky Dollar?
I don't know anyone named Lucky Dollar.
What's he want?
He says about your son.
Seabrook?
No. The other one?
Throckmorton?
I better see him.
Yes, ma'am.
Private investigator. He says Robert's alive. Pandora's Sugarland.
No,
not upset yourself, Mom. We keep home and try to get money. That's an issue.
Yeah, like
I always exactly by reputation. I'm afraid we have not the same Halloween garb.
Close, Halloween dinner.
What do you carry? 357
That must have been so finishing sweet.
So encouraging, Claire.
I don't mind.
Seabrook, leave those flies alone. They're not hurting you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Dollar, but I'm afraid you can't do it anyhow. The police are going to play clear. Besides, we don't like publicity.
We don't like private pets.
We don't like much of anything.
I need a new job.
You are a
righteous.
Thank you.
you and I haven't forgotten that college. I owe you one.
I'm going to pattern my shoes, and when I come back, I'll have a nice, long talk.
Keep your brass knuckles on the sink.
Listen, cowboy, I don't know who you are, but if you know what's good for you, you won't mention that name around here anymore.
What name?
Mono.
What's that?
The cops!
Do we have singing here or what?
Mm-hmm.
try again.
Exclusive.
ballet.
The street lights and pumpkins may go on forever, but not the public's interest. We've got to move fast.
Why do I keep feeling it would be fun, but end of all, I'm dead for us.
It would make a great finale.
Use the briefcase down here.
Use an ugly cot, your eyes beady, waiting for the governor's party. Big question coming out of music. We could get a star interested. Maybe even Kevin Costner. You could be rich.
I could be dead. Get out of here.
Lucky you've got a serious attitude problem. I'd work for just anyone.
Look, this fool.
Just call me Paul.
Look, Paul. I'm innocent.
Don't say that. I can't sell innocent. Who wants innocent?
Sorry, I'm up.
Well, you know what I'm finding when you hold your senses. I'm in the book.
Yesterday I was surprised that I'd quit my job, and today I'm a celebrity.
The public is arrested for crime, especially murder, especially if it is in society and runs around in the gorillas.
I didn't kill Throckmorton Midland.
The knife is in your hand. You stabbed in the back.
Okay. Yeah, Jeannie, that's good, but you gotta say much more out front here that Mike is gonna be down here.
Right.
Okay? And really, that rules out suicide. I mean, sort of sarcastic.
Down the street, headed back to my office. They wouldn't think I was dumb enough to ask. Besides, there's something else. seen chances are pretty good that you're the kimono.
The kimono may enter.
Whenever you're ready. How about a cheer?
The kimono returns to staff. The kimono won't stay.
Suit yourself. I can hear about it. Ah, stretch out the shelter. You can't butt the block. The cop will need your suit.
They also look for me, Mr. Dollar. A school's matter of constant love. A girl has to make a living.
You got the portal, Persia?
The kimono was hoping you had it.
Negative, but you weren't your first girl.
We had medical friends. I prevent them only because of the crow. It must return to the idol.
Say, you're awfully pale. You gotta get out when the sun is off.
Don't you grasp the situation? The crow belongs to the idol.
I have a client who says the portal was stolen from him.
That was only Montrose Hogsworth, the fat man. He stole it from the idol.
Okay. Oxford doesn't have a girl. I don't have a girl, and neither do you.
Nor does Joe Weasel. You stole the frog from Hogsworth.
Where do we go from here?
The knight from Hogsworth closes the crash to his face. This is a girl in Venice.
You're not going to see him here, surely. You're not going to see Samantha Wright.
No, Mona Le Pain.
Mona Le Pain?
She says that an engagement on the boardwalk. The kimono tried to question her. She thought I was insane and told me to get lost. The kimono has a feeling we could be better.
What?
She likes to watch detective shows on television. She likes detectives. That's your advantage.
I've got another fish to fry.
First, the pro, Mrs. Dollar. Otherwise.
Otherwise, what?
With 50 feet, the kimono snapped the rattle off its neck. I'll cut a catch in two.
I believe. Hey, Crawford was night.
You're wasting time, Mr. Dollar. Hit the boardwalk.
I think I know what you mean.
The kimono has broken.
Will you beat it? The kimono was down for herself. She was serious about returning that girl to the dragon. I didn't have much time, and everyone had to rest it. So I visited Mona Le Pain on the boardwalk. I used her for this. Most days she leaves the tape to not me. Out with the wind and the rain in my hair, out with pollution and smog in the air, me, way it doesn't hurt.
Can somebody
bring Len and steering wheel back?
get work?
What if I did? I don't know him anymore. He's dead.
Then Edward toes up. You disagree. You were so.
You talk like that crazy chick in the kimono. She said the same thing. Look, Sherlock, I run a costume shop outside. Throckmorton invented a girl suit. I was never his girlfriend.
Are you putting me on?
These lips lie.
Any idea who snipped him?
I heard of the prior detective. Your name's Lucky Dollar, by chance?
No, no, it's, Dongo.
Well, all I know is I've got one girl sitting here. Those things cost.
You love me.
I think someone's calling you.
No, she was once someone else.
Don't worry about it, Dog. I know your private eyes didn't tell from the game, but you're warning me out. But if I'm right, it's better about your work. I'll be in touch.
Thanks.
Anything for five seconds. Tim, the goblin,
good deal. Oh, Lucky, what a coincidence.
Ellie's full.
I knew the police would let you go. You could never commit murder. You're too honest, too good, too professional.
Thanks, Samantha.
That's another thing. My name really is Samantha Wright. It's Rita Everson.
Well, whatever your name is, we're back where we started.
Except for one thing. I should have mentioned it earlier, but it slipped my mind. Rockborn had a gift for me. I want to find it.
What was the gift?
He called it the Pearl of Persia.
Travis.
What?
You have hair.
You too? we'll talk later.
But Lucky.
Later.
There's no need to be rude.
Okay, okay, you got me. How'd you find
it? Yes, I'm a cop.
What?
I turned in my badge this morning. I'm thinking about being on my own.
Just what I need, competition.
Maybe I can help you. I thought I had something else left.
Yeah? He led quite a life while he did.
I couldn't figure out what he did with the money, though. He's no tracer.
I think he bought himself a
girl.
Thank you. Thanks for the tip, Dad.
Thank you.
For a guy who can't stand violence, you carry some pretty funny toys.
How do you know I was there?
Your ass is shaved. You stuck up the hallway. Smells like cabbage cooked with old spice.
My name is Kilby.
You're asleep while I saw the boardwalk at Venice Beach.
Not to be scanty, you're a fish, Mr. Dollar. I will be direct.
No bothers. I'd be careful if I were you. That kid is very important.
I sold the pearl for just not much of it worth, but you gave me all these stupid will prove to you mine. I want my money.
What makes you think I have it?
Hey, you.
Lots of people come to me. Go on, beat it. I'm allergic to the cabbage.
I don't appreciate your attitude. No, I don't.
I'll cry tomorrow. If you start moving, or I'll start kicking.
A revolver, please.
I'm keeping it as a souvenir. I'm counting three. One, two. My office had more visitors than the information booth at the Greyhound bus station. The pieces of this case scattered around like cracked bones on a bench. Somehow I had sewed it back together.
Hello, lucky.
Oh, it's you, the finishing school guy.
Did you bring your secret?
Don't hate
me. I don't hate you for being beautiful or anything else. It's just I will never use you all my required medical attention.
I know you didn't better drop
me. How can you be sure?
Instinct.
That's no substitute for logic.
What do I care about logic? Surely you get I'm mad extracted.
No offense. Risk of evolution. Lucky all the detective agency. No doubt too small, no danger at all. Lucky all the private eye industry. Yeah, I'm listening. The fear. Come along. Who is it? Who is this? Hang up.
Drop your face, Lucky. I'll make it worth your while. Money. More money than you ever had before. Money, money, money. Don't you love that word?
All you rich dames think of life. You think just because the guy's only got one pair of socks and he's hungry and his landlady kicked him out, you think you can buy him off. You can't, because I'm mad. I've been hit on the head and slugged down the job. Kiss me.
Woo!
Just as I figured, like kisses are men.
No one made it fly to me, don't
you? Go on, the thing is that way.
You'll regret having met me.
No kidding.
Swine.
She called me a swine. She ought to go back to finishing school. She's only half though. I couldn't pinpoint the voice on the phone, but it sounded vaguely familiar. But it wasn't Joe Weasel, and it wasn't Montrose Hogwarts. Since I came to the Fear of Venice Beach, it had to find the information. The information that was given to my phone. I didn't like the dogs, but I knew I had to listen.
Falling, 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 falling
bottomless rabbit hole.
You're Mrs. Midworth, and you're Claire Midworth, and you're...
start getting the best.
Thank you. Yes, you're
Got my work that I've done?
Yes.
A capable secretary.
Now down the chair.
Says I'm supposed to pick it up.
Thank you.